Hey guys, welcome to yet another interesting session by Intellipaat. We'll start off by understanding what is SAS, then we'll look at some applications of SAS, following which we'll look at the SAS program structure, and finally we'll head on to the demo part. So what is SAS? It is an analytical tool. So SAS basically stands for Statistical Analysis System. And with the help of SAS, we can perform a variety of analytical operations like time series analysis, predictive modeling, and data management. SAS is also a visualization tool. With the help of SAS, we can create beautiful graphs and also build stunning dashboards to represent our analyzed data. So now that we've understood what exactly is SAS, let's go ahead and look at some of its applications. SAS has wide applications when it comes to the finance sector. It is used in calculating credit risk on loans given by banks, credit unions, and other fintech companies. SAS can also be used for fraud prevention by continually monitoring transactions and applying behavioral analytics, which enables real-time decision-making. Now, SAS is used in the healthcare sector to identify potential issues before they become a reality, by analyzing diverse data sources to predict and medically investigate patient safety signals. It is also used to gain a more comprehensive view of patient care across a variety of conditions and procedures, by analyzing huge volumes of structured and unstructured clinical data. SAS is also used in the automotive industry for tasks such as warranty claims analytics and service parts optimization. Now we'll go ahead and look at the SAS programming structure. So any SAS program basically comprises of these two parts, data step and proc step. The data step is used to create and manage data, while proc step is used to implement different procedures for analyzing and visualizing the data. Right, we'll head on to the demo part now, and we'll be using the SAS University Edition to implement a demo. So let's go ahead and open up our SAS University Edition. Right, so I'll be using the data step to create my data set, which will be student. So this is the keyword over here, data, with which we can create our data set. And I've given the name of the data set to be student. And we need to end every statement with a semicolon. Right now, I'll go ahead and input some of the columns for the data set. So I'll say a student has a name and he has marks in three subjects. So let's say subject 1, subject 2, and subject 3. And the student also has a gender. So these are the columns for the student table. Now I'll go ahead and give the values for this data set. So I'll be using the data lines keyword. Now I'll give the values. So let's say the first student is Sam and these are his marks. And his gender is male. The next student is Anne and her marks are these and her gender is female. Next in line is Julia, who scores 90 in first subject and 12 and 12 in the next subject. Her gender is female. The next student is, let's say, Bob, who scores 50 respectively in all of the three subjects, and his gender is male. Next, we have Jeff, who scores, let's say, 78 in first subject, 34 in second subject, and 1 in the third subject, and his gender is male. The final student is Matt, who scores, let's say, 90 in first subject, 1 in second subject, and 50 in third subject. And its gender is male. Now we'll go ahead and give a semicolon so that we can signify that these are just the values which are supposed to be included in the data set. And then we'll go ahead and run this. So let's do that. Now what we see over here is we just get the marks in the three subjects, but these two columns we have dots, that is, there are no values for this. Right? So the name column and the gender column, we have just dots. And why is that happening? That is because we have not specifically told SAS that these two columns are of character type. So we need to follow the name of the column by a dollar symbol to tell SAS that these are actually character columns. Right, now let us run this and let's have a look at the result. Right, so now we see that we get the values in the name and gender column as well. Right, so this was our data step with which we were able to create the student data set. Now we'll go ahead and implement the proc step. So the first proc step or the first procedure will be the print procedure with which we'll be printing the data set. So I'll say proc print data is equal to student, and then I'll run this. Right. So this is our data set which we have printed with the proc step. Now we'll go ahead and look at proc SQL. So proc SQL basically enables us to implement SQL like commands in SAS. So let's say I would want to have a look at all of the columns and rows of the data set, and I'll be using the select star command from SQL. So I'll just type out select star from student, and I'll say quit. Right, so this command which you see over here, select star from student, this enables us to select all of the rows and columns from this data set. Let's go ahead and run this, and we get the same result. So we get the entire table comprising of all the columns and all the rows. Now what we'll do is we'll use proc SQL to find out maximum marks, minimum marks, and average marks in all of the three subjects. So let's do that. So I'll say select max of sub 1 as highest underscore sub 1, max of sub 2 as highest underscore sub 2, and max of sub 3 as highest underscore sub 3. Then we'll say from student. That is, we're selecting the maximum marks from subject 1, subject 2, and subject 3 from the student table. And we're naming those columns as highest sub 1, highest sub 2, highest sub 3. So let's go ahead and execute this. Right, so the highest marks scored by any student in subject 1 is 90, and the highest marks scored by any student in subject 2 is 78. And in subject 3, it is 89. Now, similarly, we'll go ahead and calculate the minimum marks scored by a student. So I'll say minimum of sub 1, and I'll change the column name to be lowest of sub 1. Again, minimum of sub 2 as lowest of sub 2, and minimum of sub 3 as lowest underscore sub 3 from student. Again, let's run this. Right, so the lowest marks in subject 1 is 34, and in subject 2 and subject 3 is 1. Now let's calculate the average marks. So I'll change this and say select mean of sub 1 as average underscore sub 1, mean of sub 2 as average underscore sub 2, and mean of sub 3 as average underscore sub 3 from student. Let's run this now. Right, so the average score in subject 1 is 68, average score in subject 2 is 34, and average score in subject 3 is 35. Now, what we'll do is we'll go ahead and implement some other SQL statement. Now, what I want to do is I want to see all of those rows separated by male and female students. So I'll individually do that. So what I'll do is select star from student where gender is equal to male. Let me run this. So now I have the data set which comprises of only the male students, right? So I have 4 male students over here. Similarly, if I just want the female students from the entire data set, I'll change the gender to be female. So let me run this now. This is our data set where we only have female students, and we have 2 female students over here. Right, now we'll go ahead and find out the total of all of the three subjects. let's go ahead and do that. So I'll say select star, and I'll add a new column, which will be sub 1 plus sub 2 plus sub 3. That is, I'm adding the marks of all of these three subjects, and I'm creating a new column, and I'll name that column as total. And I need this from the student data set. Right, let's run this now. So we have a new data set over here, which comprises of one extra column, which gives us the total in all of these three subjects. And with this, we can find out that Sam is the topper of the class. Right, so this was an implementation of proc SQL. Now we'll go ahead and create a new program where we'll understand looping in SAS, and we'll work with the doIndex loop. So for this, we'll be creating a factorial program. So a factorial is where you're basically trying to multiply one particular integer with all of the integers below it. So let's say if we would want to find out 5 factorial, then we'll multiply 5 with 4, 3, 2 and 1, and the result would be 120. That is, 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 will be 120. So let's go ahead and create a factorial program where we'll get the factorials for the first 10 numbers. Now I'll use the data step and create a new data set. I'll name this BA. I'll create a new variable, name it as factorial, and give the value of 1. Now I'll use the doIndex loop, and I'll type out do I is equal to 1 to 10. That is, this loop starts from 1 and goes till 10. And inside the loop, what we are going to do is we'll multiply factorial with the value of I. Right? So initially the value of factorial is 1. So 1 into 1 is 1. Then after the incrementation, value of I becomes 2. So it becomes 2 into 1. Then again after incrementation, value of I becomes 3. Then it'll become 1 into 2 into 3. And after again an incrementation, it is 4. So it'll be 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. And we'll output all of those steps. Right? And then finally we'll end the loop. So let's go ahead and run this. This actually needs to be I over here, not 1. So let's run this now. Right, so we get our factorial data set over here. So 1 factorial is 1, 2 factorial is 2, 3 factorial, that is 3 into 2 into 1 is 6, 4 factorial, which is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 is 24. And that is how we get the entire factorial table for the first 10 members. And this was an implementation of doIndex loop in SAS. Now let's head on and import a new data set into SAS and perform some sort of visualization on it. So I need to upload a file. So I'll be selecting the empty cars data set. I'll upload this. Now I need to import this. So let me go ahead and do that. Let me select the file that I've just imported. So I'll open this. Now over here, I get the code to import this file. So let me go ahead and copy all of this. And I'll open a new program. And I'll paste this over here. So this is the path where my file is stored. And this is the type of the file. And over here, I'll give the name for the file. So now I'll change import to car, because that is what I want the name of the data set to be. Let me go ahead and run this. So we have successfully imported the data set. Now let me use the proc step to have a look at the data set. So I'll see proc print data is equal to work.car, because this data set is stored in the work folder. Let me run this now. So this is a data set where we have columns such as MPG, the number of cylinders, displacement, horsepower, DRAT, weight, QSEC, VS. It basically stands for the type of the engine, either V-shaped or straight. Then we have the type of transmission, either automatic or manual. Then we have the number of gears and carburetors. All right. Now, since we have the data set with us, what we'll do is we'll go ahead and do some visualization with the help of SGPlot procedure. So I'll say proc sgplot, and I'll give the data set, which is work.car. And let's say I'll create a scatter plot, and the scatter plot will give me the distribution between mpg of the car and horsepower of the car. So for this, the command is scatter x is equal to mpg. That is, mpg is mapped onto the x column and y is equal to hp. That is, hp is mapped onto the y column. Now let me go ahead and run this. Right, so we get our graph over here, and this is a scatter plot. And what we basically understand from this graph is there is an inverse relationship between these two variables. That is, as mpg increases, horsepower decreases. And this was an implementation of sgplot in SAS. This actually brings us to the end of this video. So let's have a quick look at the summary. So we started off by understanding what is SAS. Then we looked at some of its applications, following which we looked at the SAS program structure. And then we went ahead and implemented SAS in SAS University Edition. Alright, so thank you for watching our video. And if you have any queries, feel free to contact us.
Thank you for watching our video. Do like and share it. If you have any questions, comment below and we'll respond to them as soon as possible. Also, do subscribe to Intellipaat channel so that you can keep yourself updated on the latest technologies. You can also go through other related videos in our playlist. And for more information, visit our website. Keep learning, keep improving.